What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S22 will launch in January, so we're about 3 months away from the unpacked event. But details regarding the handset keep surfacing on the internet. Today we have tons of new information about the handset, including our first ever benchmark of the S22, plus we finally have some numbers to indicate how Qualcomm's GPU is gonna stack up against the AMD and A15 Bionic chip from Apple. But first, let's take a look at the benchmark of the Galaxy S22 Plus on Geekbench. This is the Exynos 2200 variant with AMD graphics. Graphics don't matter in this test because Geekbench is purely a CPU benchmarking site, so it doesn't reflect the performance of the AMD GPU. Anyway, as you can see, these scores are way less than even the Exynos variant of the Galaxy S21. Let me explain to you why. The Exynos 2200 will use Cortex X2 cores clocking at over 3 GHz. But Samsung only used 2.59 GHz for this test, and that's the biggest reason for these low scores. Additionally, the Galaxy S22 will use the latest ARM V9 architecture, but the Geekbench 5 is not compatible with that yet, and that's why it chose as V8. They will update the site later on, and when they do, these scores should go up. So coupled with a higher clock frequency, the multi-core score should comfortably surpass 4000. That said, we've seen GPU benchmarks of both the AMD and A15 Bionic on the iPhone 13. AMD shattered all the previous records in the GPU test until the new A15 Bionic chip was benchmarked, which managed to surpass the AMD-Samsung combo with these impressive scores. So all eyes were on Qualcomm. How are they going to respond to these massive improvements in graphics from their competitors? Well, today the new Adreno GPU on the Snapdragon 898 has been benchmarked, and here are the scores. If we compare this with AMD and A15 Bionic chip, then scores are much lower. But the Adreno GPU on the Snapdragon 898 has a key advantage over its competitors. You see, both AMD and Apple have focused on peak performance, while Qualcomm on sustained performance. This means if you play games for a longer period of time, both AMD and A15 will throttle, hence reducing the performance. You won't have that problem with the Snapdragon 898. I'm not saying it won't throttle ever, but it will take a longer time to throttle than the AMD and A15 Bionic. But in any case, all the new chipsets will offer significant improvements in the GPU performance compared to their predecessors. With that said, we have some more information about the Galaxy S22 Ultra's camera setup. It's more or less the same camera setup as the S21 Ultra, except the zoom cameras are expected to feature variable zoom lenses. Oppo showcased this technology, and it does make a world of difference to the quality at non-native zoom levels. Samsung will still use a punch hole 40-megapixel camera at the front, and it's not an under-display camera, which is the right move considering the quality of these cameras are horrible at the moment. Anyway, do consider subscribing for all the latest tech news, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.